Hi, welcome to this video. Let me show you what I've got here. This is a CB2 micro kit. It's a little retro do-it-yourself computer based on an 18 mega microcontroller. It was designed a few years ago by Jörg Wolfram, and now Kostas in Greece has made a kit with a PCB, and you get all the parts that you need to build it. So let's take a look and see what's inside the bag. Be careful not to lose any of the small parts. Now let's first take a look at the PCB. It's just hole through components, so no SMD soldering is required. And it's quite compact, as you can see, but be aware that there is not enough room for fitting a socket for the 80 mega, because the parts here are so close together that there's just not enough room. So we'll have to solder the 80 mega directly to the PCB. Now let's take a look at the main components. This is the 80 mega, the heart of the CB2 micro. It's already pre-programmed and it will go here. Then we have this SCART connector. Display output will be over RGB SCART, which is great news for most of us here in Europe and also in some other parts of the world, because this gives a very sharp picture both on your modern LCD television and also on your old CRT television. As far as I know, in North America these connectors have not been very popular, so there you'll probably end up using some SCART2 HDMI converter to connect your CB2 micro to your television. Then we have this PS2 connector. Here we'll connect a standard PC keyboard to our CB2 micro. Then there is this RS232 connector for transferring data from and to our little computer. And finally, we have this little mini USB connector for power supply. You can use a standard 5-volt cell phone charger, but be aware that this is not micro USB that you're used to from your cell phone. Mini USB looks like this. In fact, this cable came with the first digital camera that I ever bought. It was a Canon IXUS back in 2004, and also many external hard disks still use this type of connector. Okay, and there's a few smaller parts that we have to solder, and I think that's it, and we are ready to build it. So let's see what we will get. Now, when you build your kit, just follow the instructions on the web page. The parts are soldered in the order of the height so that the smallest parts go first. I've already soldered the crystal, and next will be the 80 mega. And notice this little mark, which goes here. And to make the chip fit inside the holes, you may need to bend the pins a little inward so that it fits. And there we go. So now we are ready to solder the 80 mega. Okay, just do one pin after the other. Okay, that's it. So, after some time of soldering, my little CB2 micro seems to be complete now. All the parts have been fitted, and that's what it looks like. And, well, let's better not take a close look at the underside, because I'm not very experienced at soldering, and I will never win a beauty contest for that, but I hope that it still works. So, I think we are ready to power it up for the first time. Okay, this is the moment of truth now. I have connected a PS2 keyboard and a SCART cable, which goes to this TV set. And I have connected a cell phone charger. And there's the red button that I'll press now, and let's just see what will happen. And we have a picture. And it seems to be working. I think that's fantastic. I have currently no idea what to do with it. I'll just try to press a key, and it seems to be working. I think we have a working new little computer. I've been playing for about 5 minutes with my new little toy, and let me just show you what I found. There's a few demo programs pre-installed on it, and let's just try this little game. Okay, just listen to the sound. It's a beautiful little retro machine. So that's it. I hope you enjoyed watching this video, and see you next time. Bye bye.